Breaking tonight, 13 children, boys and girls, say they were sexually assaulted by their elementary school teacher and youth soccer coach. Last weekend, we told you Hector Manley was accused of molesting three girls at Parkside Elementary School. Today, we've learned 10 more children have come forward, all of them under the age of 12, claiming Manley touched their private areas in the hallway, at the water fountain, in class, and then even threatened to kill their parents if they reported him.
The school district fired Manley earlier this week. His social media accounts are full of photos of him surrounded by kids from the classroom to the soccer field. We're blurring all the kids' faces to protect their identities. But in one picture, you see him with the kids that he coached. NBC2's Nestor Montoya is live at the fields where the team played after talking to a man who has seen Manley interact with those kids.
Well, after school, Manley would coach a soccer team known as Parkside United. In fact, they were one of a few teams that made up the Mexi Soccer League. And earlier, we talked to the director who tells us he is both shocked and sickened to learn about those allegations against Manley, but tells me he knew something was off when Manley texted him last week out of the blue, letting him know that he wouldn't be coming to practice that day. Miguel Nino, who is the director for the Mexi Soccer League, says Manley was loved by parents and the kids he coached. Manley, a double amputee, admired for the version of himself he portrayed on social media. He says Manley, like the other coaches in the league, had to pass a background check, which he did. It was only recently that 13 of his victims, all under 12 years old, brought the disturbing allegations to light.
How can you not admire someone with that condition who was also a teacher and worked with kids? You'd never imagine anything would happen. The kids trusted him as much as the parents trusted him. And that was an error, one that we and the other parents were never able to detect.
And the league's director tells us there's about 300 to 400 children who play every week in the league. He tells me that as for Parkside United, those parents have since stepped up to assist in coaching duties while Manley sits in jail. I'm live in Naples, Nestor Montoya, NBC2.